So welcome. In this section, we would understand rural development schemes under Kurukshetra September edition. So most of this talks about how developments have taken place in the rural area, how raw materials can be procured, and what are the various activities which have been witnessed in different parts of the country. For example, in Andhra Pradesh, it is kalamkari. In Arunachal Pradesh, it is carpet manufacturing, pottery. In Bihar, we have carpet, glasswork, wood. Work. So those are some of the lists that has been mentioned here. Applique is one of the techniques of knitting, which is basically thread work, which is done in Himachal Pradesh. Rani silk sari weaving in Tamil Nadu, and so on. So basically, when we focus on handicrafts, it is cotton, silk handlooms, leather manufacturing, musical instruments, toys, jewelry products, pottery, embroideries, carpets, khadi, and wood products. Now, in rural area, we have been seeing a lot of challenges. What are those? First is the seasonal production, then low demand in the rural area, and limited access to good remuneration. Also, the distribution channels are not proper. To solve this, there has been lots of emphasis on rural marts, commercial organizations coming in, skilling up the people. So upskilling, digital marketing, the government e-marketplace, good branding strategies, bringing the self-help groups in line with the marketing agencies and bringing in more collaboration. So rural product, we have seen what is important. First of all, product, how it can be well placed, a good distribution strategy for the product strategy that fits in the market demands, the good pricing, and then finally promotion is important. So product strategy basically talks about, as we mentioned, the affordability, convenience, product appeal and protection of goods and products. Pricing strategy talks about geotagging and highlighting the nature of products. Promotion focuses on assisting the rural and urban consumers with cultures and across cultures and personality. Product placement, right, working on the right distribution, logistics, and controlled marketing. Rural shopping malls and rural marts are another some examples. Now, brand management, we talk about GI tags, which is geographical indicators. Now, Darjeeling was the first to obtain the GI tag in 2004. The highest GI tags have been obtained for fruits, followed by vegetables. And then we have also given cultural significance to various works. For example, Madhubani painting of Bihar has been given cultural significance, and so on and so forth. Now, the rural product branding definitely has numerous challenges. The literacy levels are not good. There are brands which are not considered as assets. The deprived market facilities are seen. Also, we have seen that we need to use more of GI tags. As a result, we can create brand ambassadors, hub and spoke model, which was for Coca-Cola, Project Shakti for HUL, Utsav campaigns for Asian Paints, and so on. So we need to focus on allied activities with agriculture. So focusing on self-help groups, producer groups, farmer producer organization, cooperatives, and similar interest groups are important. Now, there have been challenges in the field of agriculture, trade, climatic conditions, capital endowment. So all those are certain challenges. To strengthen those, we have a good network, a marketing infrastructure. So ENAM, that is the Electronic National Agricultural Marketplace, has been established. Grameen agricultural markets through grams, which are the rural hearts being converted into grams. Then agricultural market funds, we have the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana for rural road development. So all this affects collectively into the development. APMC mandis, the producer market committees have been strengthened. We need to focus on what is the marketing channel, how better investments can be brought, what is the awareness strategy which can be promoted for better marketing of the products, and how APMC mandis and the village agricultural markets can procure the wholesale agriculture and then sell it to the right price to the right people. So agri value chain infrastructure is again important, because here where we need to look into uncertainties, any kind of managerial competencies and opportunities for innovation. So the next important focus nowadays is contract farming. So with the changing agricultural laws, we are talking about contract farming, where the contract would be given to the farmer and that produce would be procured by the organization who has given the contract. So that's the whole concept of contract marketing, and this would further boost the agricultural crops which were outside the MSP ambit. So more of food crops, more of aromatic crops can be now brought into account through this. But rural agriculture, rural marketing faces a definite issue. What are the challenges? The challenges are in terms of spare parts, power supply, lower price to the farmers, inaccessible internet. So we say e-marketplace, so e-naam, that becomes difficult if the internet is not proper. A huge proportion is basically small and marginal farmers. So challenges to those again become important. Now, some of the schemes, as we have already been discussing throughout various editions, is the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, that is basically development of rural roads, all weather roads to a population of up to 500 people in plains and 250 and above in the special category states or the desert areas. Then we have Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana, which is basically bringing in electricity supply to regulate the supply to the farm areas. Saubhagya scheme talks about electricity connection to the rural households. Digital infrastructure through BharatNet project, which aims at broadband connectivity into the rural India, connecting nearly 2.5 lakh gram panchayats across India. Then we also focus on the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas, which is basically skill and apprenticeship development. What can be the steps that can be taken? Farmer producer organization and the companies related to the same. Now, there have been various central schemes for the same. So, one district, one product, a cluster-based approach and community-based approach are some of these. So, Maharashtra Agricultural Competitive Project is one of the major projects that has come up. The cost of marketing has been significantly lowered by 31% in this case, and 28% of the members have purchased inputs through this project. So, again, an important development that we had witnessed. Now, physical marketing and agricultural marketing schemes both are important. So agricultural marketing schemes mainly aim at doubling the market, doubling the agriculture farm income. So related to irrigation, logistics, any kind of local retail market, and electronic naam, the e-naam portal has been working definitely great. So there has to be a market information from primary level to wholesale, to the market terminal, and finally for the export, and that is how the grams level work. Then we also talk about the various programs and policies which relate to agri-export, the market reform models like APLMC, which is mainly for the promotion, essential commodities, the farmer producer organization, Sichai Yojana. Then you have Rashtriya Gokul Mission for Animal Husbandry, Blue Revolution for Fisheries, Interest Subvention Scheme, Kisan Credit Card, also working on creating integrated scheme for agricultural marketing to have value chain, cold storage, a national unified agriculture market. We need to focus more on how facilities can be provided so that farmers can sell the produce directly to e-naam. Even for the cold storage, how it can be maintained. E-naam portal is now also available in other languages besides English. So the available languages, the list has been mentioned here. Kisan Rath mobile app has been started by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare. And this is a farmer-friendly mobile app. It talks about the vehicles suitable for transportation of their agriculture and horticulture products, how the post-loading partial loading can take place. So all those details can be availed through this. Also, we need to understand what constitutes the rural market is important. So there are various elements to it: urban to rural, rural to rural, and rural to urban. So what kind of transaction of species, spices and species and plant products take place across these categories have been mentioned. So again, an important thing that we need to understand. Then e-commerce, definitely with e-commerce developing, financial inclusion coming in, digital developments in BharatNet, agriculture in the rural areas have transformed a lot. There has been more traditional and personal means of communication which have been introduced. So what are the traditional and the digital means of communication we have mentioned here? Then we have the state rural livelihood mission which can be included. So Palash Mart in Bihar is one such example for the same. Then we also have Saras Collection, which is for the rural self-help group, and this has been started by the Commerce Ministry. It basically displays five categories: handicraft, handloom, office accessories, grocery, personal care and hygiene. It has been developed by NIC as an online Mela software to basically automate the National Rural Livelihood Mission Ajivika Mela, and this has been attended by numerous artisans. We are also focusing on futuristic growth, where we need to focus on consumer rights, laws, basically GST pricing, Panchayati Raj. We have four major committees which have been dealt with. So Balwant Rai Mehta, Ashok Mehta, GVK Roy and LM Singhvi committee are the most important ones. The 73 Constitutional Amendment Act, which was added in the part 9th of the constitution, talks about the purview of Panchayati Raj, and this becomes justifiable under the constitution. So how the Panchayati Raj systems would be independent of the state government will. Women representation of 33% would be provided, and there would be provisions where up to 50% reservation would be meant for certain categories, and only 1/3 of the seat for the women would be reserved. Now, there have been various responsibilities of the panchayat. Now, these responsibilities are some of the mandatory functions, which are civic and regulatory functions, the general functions, the sectoral functions, which are mainly related to planning, implementation. Then we also have a citizen charter, which is Meri Panchayat, Mera Adhikar, Jan Sevaye Aapke, Hamare Dwar. So those are some of the efforts that have been lauded. And then audit online application is another important application by Ministry of Panchayati Raj, which facilitates online auditing of all the accounts, and this maps and strengthens the partnership. E-Gram Swaraj portal is a unified portal to monitor and evaluate the works which have been done through Panchayati Raj institutions, and it improves the tracking activities of the Panchayati Raj institutions. So another important portal that we need to know about. Similarly, we have seen that agricultural strategies have been important. So prevention of COVID and the protocol that has been given to prevent the COVID infection has been mentioned here. A similar model we have seen in Karnataka. So it is known as HOPCOMS model, which is Horticulture Producer Marketing and Processing Cooperative Society Limited. And this is started with the Karnataka government. Special passes for marketing have been issued. There has been a special procurement and special passes for supplied food. Fruits and vegetables have been taken into account. We have various similar models which have been operated by Karnataka state. For example, mango development and marketing is one such model. Similarly, in the Puthari FPO, there is another promotion which is done by Krishi Vigyan Kendra, and this is in the regions of Kodagu, and the services have been provided through the Rural Mart. A similar model has been started in Andhra Pradesh in Palamnar. We have also similar models in Karnataka, operated by Tenseri, Shenoy Fruits, and then we have Village Story. So these are some of the private institutions working in line for the development. So there has to be an initiative which has to be lauded through social media, promoted through social media, then the sellers, where you have collection, grading and direct linking to the consumers that take place. And finally, this would lead to better connectivity, any removal of extra middlemen, better price to the producer, and a sustained linkage with longer term relationship. Similarly, ICT has been working greatly in rural areas. We have Kisan Suvidha as an important portal on weather patterns and agricultural advisories. Digital Mandi India app has been working with the latest mandi prices. We have also been focusing on dairy farming, food processing and so on. One district, one product is another scheme to improve the supply chain and e-commerce in India. The 75th Independence Day highlights focused on rural areas and how drone facilities can help the rural areas. Swamitva scheme is one such scheme through which the mappings would be done. Mission Poshan, another important scheme for fortification that has to be achieved by 2024, and then we have various health and wellness centers to be built across the country. So those are some of the important developments in rural areas. We would be covering many more interesting lectures on Yojana Kurukshetra and Down to Earth, so stay subscribed, and in the links below we have the detailed description of the content which is available here. Wish you very good luck for your preparation.